Favourite occupies gate one. Likely to follow the hot speed of the mare Olga Louisa. Red light is on. Olga Louisa to steady. Off and racing. State of Power actually beat her out, but Olga Louisa will burn across now and take over. Pixie Chicks up on the outside, running third soon after the start, followed further back then by Athlone Castle. Rockin' Rupert in the back half of the field as they gallop down the side. Dance Cocky drifting right back there, and towards the tail is Ghost Who Walks. Olga Louisa's being allowed to run by the fish. Whiting has broken open the field there, and he's got a commanding lead. 500 to go. Olga Louisa, she's flying side. Solo, led by six or seven. Running second is the favourite, State of Power. Now caught in two minds whether to chase and see if it comes back to it, but it's got ground to make. Olga Louisa still leads down to the 250. Four in front, State of Power under the shillelagh coming now from Pixie Chicks. Ghost Who Walks for the back. 120 to go. State of Power getting up on the inside of Olga Louisa. Here's State of Power and down the outside Pixie Chicks, but State of Power, Pixie Chicks dived. Pixie Chicks dive right on the line. Nearly a dead heat, almost a dead heat. State of Power, Pixie Chicks, Ghost Who Walks probably third from the tiring Olga Louisa, and they were followed home by Rockin' Rupert, next home Athlone Castle and Dance Cocky. Wow, great finish. State of Power, Holly Watson in the unenviable task of having to try and take out the leader Olga Louisa, who had them running. And Pixie Chicks with a dive late. We tack on a little to the outside horse always, but State of Power holds on. Number three, State of Power, has beaten Pixie Chicks. Ghost Who Walks will be third. Olga Louisa fourth in another desperately close go. We've seen a few in the first four races at Belmont Park this afternoon. These gripping finishes continue on. State of Power holds the victory for Simon Miller and Holly Watson. Tough ask for Watson there to chase one who led by a conservative six at the top of the straight and then to drag the others to it. You've just got to decide when to go the trigger. And she rode like a demon in the last little bit to get to Olga Louisa and then hold off the challenge of Chixie Picks, who dived right at her on the line but has just failed to pick it up. Ghost Who Walks back there in the field, deep, never on the track, running on to grab third for Brandon Louis. State of Power, what a model of consistency this mare is, by Dream Ahead from Fully Chargeable, for the Zito brothers at J&M Smash Repairs, great supporters of racing, and certainly Tab Radio, MRG, Zito, also Mark Harvey, Mrs. H, P.G. Burrell, Kim Hyman, Lex Piper, Mrs. L. Wade, K. Wade, Rick Mayo, Mrs. T. Kershaw, D. Kershaw, and Ms. C. Waterhouse. And she's now got five from 21 and just simply doesn't run average races. Great effort to hold on and win. Pixie Chick second by Rommel from Snow Pixie, David Harrison and Paul Harvey. And Ghost Who Walks is a God Has Spoken, Death Not Gilding, Brandon Louis, the rider for Nifty Neville Parnham. So those margins are a nose and a length. Second nose result here this afternoon. And the racing's certainly been action-packed. So here's Holly coming back aboard this mare that she has got a real passion for. And she's a lovely mare. And she's just so genuine as the connections now greet her back there. The Zetos, Rick Mayo and all the team involved here with this mare. The Amelia Park Handicap Race, 5 over 1,600. 6 LALA is out. Pat Carberry goes on to One Brother Paddy. Vital Flirt gets the services of Troy Turner in the next on the program. Britt joins us, and there is nothing like a Bonnie Mare who continues to race so well.
Unbelievable preparation she has had. Start number 14 of the campaign today, and yet another victory, always in the money. Kelly Kinnamont joins me now. And Kel, you must just be so proud of her and her consistency in such a long campaign.
Yeah, she's a real gutsy little mare now. I think that's a record for our stable to have 14 starts for this campaign. So a little bit of a freshen up in between, but She keeps pulling up so well. I mean, what more can you do? At least there's not another race for another 3 weeks, so I think she's earned a spell.
You might think it is a little break there. Will she go around in 3 weeks' time? Is that the plan?
I don't believe so.
It's paddock time now, no matter what?
Yeah, I think so. I think she's definitely deserved the paddock.
Well, she definitely has, but racing so consistently, as you mentioned, so it's been hard to put her out. What's she been like in the stable? Because it can be really hard to keep a horse up this sort of long, particularly in an Ascot environment.
Yeah, she goes in the pool and she's normally bouncing around, coming out of the pool. She's pretty much standard every time. Same as like Ginger Flyer, you know, they're just amazing.
Well, she has had an excellent campaign. Well done, too.
Thanks, Brian.
There is Kelly Kinmon. Let's get over to Holly Watson.
Well, we're talking to Holly Watson here after the victory of State of Power. Holly, this is a mare who led last start, and today you probably at stages would have been 5, 6, 7 lengths off Olga Louisa. Gee, she's quick.
Yeah, definitely. We always knew that mare is very quick and they just let it do what it wants and hang off. So always knew I was going to get the rails run, and we know how tough my mare is. So.
At what stage did you start to think I need to start bridging this gap?
When we were coming around the corner and it was still a couple of lengths in front of me, I just sort of niggled at her a bit and I could just feel her just chasing and chasing. We know she's got an awesome kick on her, so yeah.
Could you hear Paul Harvey coming?
Yeah, I did actually think I got rolled for a second, so I had to come across with my head down, and then I was like, oh, we did win. So, yeah, very brave.
Kelly was saying 14th run for her this preparation. She's been a model of consistency, but she's also been up for a long, long time. She's definitely a mare that's pretty tough.
Oh, you can't fault her. She's so tough, and every single run she puts in, and, you know, if you just get nabbed on the line, she's still up there, but just ultra consistent.
Congratulations.
Thanks, Scott.
There is Holly Watson combines with Simon Miller in State of Power, wins race number 4, defeats Pixie Chicks in a photo. 3, 5, 2 and 6, the numbers from the 4th.